Hey.
It's August. What are the updates?
The original plan was to have today, August 12th, to have a Blender beta release. Unfortunately, we're not going to make it because I mean we've basically instead of finishing all the features today, we've had to do a lot of work to stabilize existing features. Make Blender more stable and sort of catch up with things after the code quest, which means that the Blender beta is being delayed, and the new plan is basically to have a Blender beta that's feature complete, a Blender 2.8 beta, by the Blender conference, which is at the end of October.
And if we don't make that.
Well, we have to make it. I mean, basically, I think there's during the code quest, a lot of new features were added, a lot of things were added which were not originally planned, which are, really useful, but at the same time, you also have to, really release something. And so basically the plan is now we have to release by the end of October, and if something is not ready by that time, we just move it like to 2.81, 2.82, and so on. So we're just sort of organizing things around making that date.
And a final release, we can expect it for early next year.
Yeah, I think like early next year somewhere. Basically, if we have all the features by the Blender conference, we'll need a few more months to, just deal with all the bug fixes and the bug, all the reports that we'll be getting, to make it really, actually usable, where we could actually say like, you can use this for an actual project and, we try to really support this.
Nice. So by the conference, we can expect the bug tracker to open.
Yeah, I mean, right now it's open for crashes in Blender 2.8, and then it will be open more generally for more bug reports, just any kind of bug. And it might be even before the Blender conference, but we haven't set a specific date yet for that.
Awesome. What's new in the Alpha 2?
Well, the big new thing is Crease Pencil. So that's been a long time coming, and now you can, just now Blender has like a full 2D animation toolset, basically. There's a few other things like an EV light cache for baking light, and there's new default matte caps, and there's also some things not necessarily related to 0.8, but there's Summer of Code projects. For example, we now have a principled hair shader for cycles. We have improved bevel tools. We have improved normal editing tools. So those are kind of like an extra bonus in 2.8 now.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much.
Okay, thank
See you
you.
soon. Hey, so yes, you heard it. Blender 2.8 Alpha is coming out, Alpha 2 is coming out today. Yeah, you may be waiting for the beta, but as we seen the beta, it's moved towards the end of October. That is the Blender conference, which will have like a more feature complete library. Everything that was planned before, it was basically, yeah, it's the same, but it was moved towards the end of October because the Alpha 2 means because there are many things that were added since the Alpha, and there are many things that were implemented that were not expected, like it was mentioned in the video. So there is a Grease Pencil that was expected. There is some Summer of Code projects that were not expected, but they are awesome to have them on board, like the principal hair shader we see in the video, and that one for cycles, it was amazing. Then there is the new normals editing, new bevel, custom matcaps that was planned, but still so many open projects are left for Blender 2.8, that is better to play it safe, move the date forward. So today, when you open it, you will see, when you open 2.8, you will see this Alpha 2 with a beautiful splash screen from the Hero Open project. Just because this Alpha 2 is all about Grease Pencil, most of it. There is also, as we said, there is a custom matcap, but if you follow the development, there you already know this stuff. If you want to know more about it, you can always check the blog that Brecht wrote about what came out, all the new stuff, what is being worked on at the moment. And if you want to know even more about how it's being worked on, you can see here in the workboard all the projects that are being worked on, all the tasks, the individual tasks that are worked on, and everything that comes with it. The ones, maybe some of them are all we are working on trying to sort them. But as you can see here, for example, all the Spring bags, which Spring is the open movie project that is happening here, the Blender Animation Studio, that is using Blender 2.8 every day for production. So as you can see, most of them are crashes or like transform, copy on write, all the heavy stuff. Yeah, there are some topics in the interface that are missing that are still need work. There is the workspaces, there are all the things that need to be tackled. The tool system is still not there. The top bar is still not there. There is so much, but things are moving forward. Of course, after the Code Quest, after 3 months with 10 developers here in one place, things are move so fast that now it feels like it's moving actually slower. But right now, it's not about adding new stuff like this today. It's about fixing those stuff, making it stable. And yeah, there are less developers under this roof to work on it. There are many developers that are working online. They're working on that from their own place. But some of them are maybe part-time because the resources that we had during the Code Quest, thanks to the crowdfunding, were much bigger. You can make this 2.8 happen faster if you join the development fund. This is the main way. You can, of course, also go to the Blender store. You can go to the Blender cloud. But if you don't care about the cloud or the store or whatever, you only want to focus on development, that development fund is the way to get it, to move it forward. This is what makes Blender stable, what makes people work on fixing and implementing new features. And like Eevee came out of the development fund, like big part of the grants were here, for example, grant for Clement to work on Eevee for 3 months, and then 6 months for the viewport development also. Like everything happens through the development funds nowadays. So if you can, please consider joining with the bronze. You can go as low as €5, you can go 10, 15, 25. If you have a company, you can go even higher. We are working on a new, better development fund that you can, it's similar to what happened with the Code Quest. So if you have a big, if you have a studio or a company and you want to show off your support for Blender 2.8 and Blender in general, you can pick on the higher ones and get a logo and all this stuff. This will happen very soon. We are working on it as if we speak right now, but this is the way to get things forward. You can also contribute by submitting crash reports. At the moment, the backtracker, like Brecht said, is not going to be open until maybe October, maybe earlier, but yes, towards closer to the beta. So for the time being, if you find any crashes in Alpha 2 and over, you can go to the help menu and report a bug. This is the main way to move things forward. And of course, providing feedback in the Dev Talk forum is always welcome. It's always so nice to see people involved in this huge, huge milestone, which is Blender 2.8. Yes, it's good to take time to make things nice. The wait will be worth it. Of course, everybody wants to have it immediately. I want to have it ready like tomorrow, but good things, you know, they're worth the wait. So let's wait together, stay in touch. Follow this channel if you want to continue receiving news. You can subscribe, you can give it likes, you can leave comments. And I will see you again in the next video. Thank you for staying in.